Hi, my name is Sebastian. I'm here today to talk to you about Darfon and their products, and this is the hybrid inverter. So we're gonna go ahead, just start opening it, get ready. As you can see, this is the terminals. We're gonna get to them. We're gonna open the top part as well for the communication. There we go, this is for the first step. The following step will be to open the battery box, open the batteries as well, and start connecting the batteries so we could power up the inverter and start the programming for it. Okay, so this part now is done. We're ready to mount the batteries inside the cabinet. So before you start mounting the batteries inside the cabinet, you want to start them, make sure they're at 50% state of charge. That means that we're good to go. Close them back up, and we're gonna unpack the other three as well. Okay, so we have the first module installed, we have the brackets to secure, and we're gonna repeat this step three more times to have all four batteries inside, and then we'll move on to connecting the wiring and the dip switches. inside here, you're gonna see there's a little lock for the battery door. Once it's locked, it's secure and nobody can get in anymore. Now that we have the battery secured in the enclosure, we're gonna start wiring the grounds to each individual battery, and then we're gonna connect the little on-off switches. They're gonna power the whole batteries at once. So this step now, it was to connect all of the batteries to the grounds. So the grounds are all connected to the box. The box will also be grounded to the inverter after. The switches on off are all connected to every single battery. So you have a master on off here to connect all the four batteries. All over here, the dip switches are already placed in order. So the batteries are all in order. So you have battery one, battery two, battery three, and battery four. The next step will be to connect the RG45 so the communication continues through the batteries. The RG45s are all connected. Now we're gonna put the terminators. The terminators are gonna explain which one is the first battery and which one is the last one in the line. So next step we're gonna follow, we're gonna connect the wire that's gonna bring the connection from the batteries to the inverter. So they talk to each other to know the percentage of state of charge. We're gonna leave this wire here, we're gonna pass it into the grommet after all the battery wires. So we're gonna remove all the little red caps this time to get ready to plug the batteries together. So now that the caps are all removed, you're going to be able to plug the wires from positive to negative to the parallel. I like to start always with the longest wire, so it's an easier wire management, so we're able to move it around and then we'll go to the smallest connections. So now the batteries are connected to each other. You're just missing the two terminals that are going to go to the inverter to connect. That's the next step. Okay, so the battery is all wired up right now. What we're gonna do, we're gonna re-put the enclosure, the cabinet here to close it. The beauty about the cabinet here also is that you always have an indicator of the state of charge of your battery at the same time. So you could always view here, once the battery is gonna power it on, you're gonna be able to see the state of charge. At this point, the battery is all set up. The box is ready. We're gonna connect everything to the inverter and we'll be able to start it up. So one of the first wire we're gonna connect. As you can see here at the bottom, we have different kind of knockouts. The knockouts will be for AC, DC communication, whichever you like. You have different sizes, easy to pop open. I will not open them today, we're just going to connect directly inside. Okay, at this point, we're going to introduce also the data logger, the DARFON DL. I'll put it here as an example. It's going to be connected at the same time right next to the battery. So this is what's going to be able to monitor the DARFON over internet and keep data and have all the stats of the progression year by year, week by week, day by day, hour by hour. So you're going to be able to monitorize, get all the also alerts if there's any problems with the system itself. So this one will connect. Oh, I'm just going to jump on the side. It connects right over here on the left side. The right side is only for the other wire that comes from the battery. So this is really the communication area. So now technically this would be connected to internet either by LAN, straight by wire, or it can be connected also by Wi-Fi to your system. I'm gonna keep this aside for now. Now we're gonna move on to the batteries, connect the ground. I personally like to start with the ground. And the beauty about the DARFON is that there's a lot of room inside to work also inside this box. Okay, now we're continuing. We're gonna plug the cable battery wires. We're gonna start with the negative one. Cover for the protection. Always make sure that it's off position, the breaker. And we're gonna move on to the negative. The positive side. So now here, everything is connected as far as the battery itself. First thing, we're gonna start the battery with the main switch. Batteries are starting. We're at 50%. And we're gonna start the inverter. For our goods. And on the side, we have a switch for the inverter. As you see on the screen, it's fired up. 0 hours. Battery, it's recognized, it's not yet recognizing the percentage, but it's gonna come. Here you have some indications of the future PV1, PV2. This is a beauty because this inverter has two inputs for PV. As you can see here, you have PV1, PV2. You have a grid input, so you can come in with 240 volts. You have load out, you have load one out, load one two. You have two load outs, actually. 240 also, split phase. On this side, this part over here, it's if you want to connect a generator to it to charge the batteries as well in case of an off-grid situation, or just to charge the batteries if there's not enough sun in that situation. I'm gonna move up to the screen over here. You have all the indicators when the PV is connected. You're gonna be seeing how many kilowatts, how many volts each string is gonna give you. You're gonna see how much is pulled out of the battery. You see also in the load how much the house is gonna be pulling from the load out. Here you're gonna be able to put in different modes like that. You're gonna have to put the date, the time. You could see also at the bottom, the battery type that you have. You're gonna have to program, make sure you have the LFP battery, 14-6125. And it's a single mode. You have different strings. This one is gonna be plugged as one unit, so it's gonna be on the single at the same time. You have different modes after also that you could program. This inverter could be just programmed to be a backup mode. In case of a power failure, you just want it to be like a standby generator kind of thing. It could be powering loads at all times. It could be also using time of use. So if there's hydro is gonna eventually get to that, gonna charge more during rush hours, you're gonna be able to empty your batteries at that time if you want to. That's very practical at the same time. And it's pretty much as easy as that. When this is connected, you'll be able to see everything on the portal online at all times.